As you explore different data science tutorials and watch different data science videos, one of the things they're always talking about is preparing your data and the time you spend preparing your data. One of the things you'll end up doing as you prepare your data is you're going to have to either remove columns from a data frame, or you might need to take some of the columns inside a data frame and move them into a separate one, sort of splitting them off, if you will. So let's explore how you do that with the Python code as well. So in this case, maybe I have something like the actual arrival time column. If I was doing some data science and I was trying to predict how many minutes late a flight was going to be, and that's a value inside of arrival delay. Well, if I had the actual arrival time and the scheduled arrival time, well, I can just calculate arrival delay by subtracting one from the other. But I'm trying to train a model to look at all the other factors, like what airport did it leave from, and what time did it leave, and how long was the flight, and use those values to try and predict if the flight's later on time. So I don't just want to say take the actual arrival time and subtract the scheduled arrival time. Not a really training a model, that's just doing a subtraction. So in this case, I might need to remove the actual arrival time column. So how do I do that with Python code? Well, there is, I'm sure you're discovering by now, Pandas has some fantastic features, and the data frame object has a drop method. So you can simply say drop a particular column. So if I say, hey, on my delays data frame, let's drop the column called actual arrival time. And then what this does, it doesn't actually modify the delays data frame. It simply returns a new data frame, which contains everything except the actual arrival time. So I get a new data frame containing everything except actual arrival time. If, however, you want to make the change to the delays data frame itself, you can actually specify in place equals true. And that's a way of saying modify the data frame where I'm doing the drop. So that way I don't have to copy the values to a new data frame. I'm just saying, no, modify this one right here. And that will simply drop the actual arrival time column from delays data frame. Now, the other thing you might need to do sometimes is you might need to take some of the columns from a data frame and move them aside. One of the most common things you'll hear people talk about in data science courses is the idea of qualitative data and quantitative data. So qualitative data is descriptive data. It's things like, what airport is it? And are things blue or green or gold? They're describing things. But quantitative data tends to be numbers. How big is something? How long is something? How many minutes the delay was, and so on. And you'll discover as you explore data science that those quantitative values, training models, they love that type of data. So quite often, we have to take those quantitative values and pull them aside to use them to train our model. So in this case, that's my origin airport and my destination airport. So I can simply create a slice of that data frame and kick back to that module Christopher showed you where we talked about how to query a data frame. So basically, I'm going to query the data frame to return just those two columns and then take those two columns and put them in a new value. So all you do is you do a query using, I'm using loc here. And remember that first colon means which rows do I want back, and a single colon means return all rows. And then you specify which columns you want, in this case, origin airport and destination airport, and take those values and put them into description data frame. And that will create this nice new data frame for me with just the columns that I need. So these techniques are going to make it easier for you when you start having to prepare your data for data science. Now let's take a try doing it in code.